In this video, we're continuing the work, no pun intended, that we started on section 6.4, where we discuss mechanical work in terms of integration. So while we have already seen how to calculate work done by a non-constant force, we're now going to examine a variety of non-constant forces. Namely, two specific examples here that we're going to discuss. And the difference, though, is that we actually need to think about these problems not in terms of finding the force function, but by actually doing the setup of the infinitesimal work. So this is a slightly different technique than what we've grown accustomed to, but ultimately it's not too bad, okay? So our first example here, we imagine that there's a heavy cable that's 300 pounds and 100 feet long, and it hangs off the side of a building. And our question is, how much work, mechanical work, is required to pull it to the top? Now, speaking from personal experience of pulling something up, you may understand intuitively that it's hardest at first, because you're pulling on the whole weight, and then as you pull more and more, there's less weight, and so it becomes easier. So you may anticipate that as you're accounting for more length of the cable, the work done is larger, and as you have less cable to work with, then the less work you would need. Okay, so let's think about how to set up the work calculation. We know fully that the work is going to be from the full length of the cable to from x equals 0 to x equals 100, and we need to add up the f of x dx. But what is this infinitesimal work? So the infinitesimal work, well, let's break up this cable into tiny segments of equal length dx. Or we can call it dx, or we can call it delta x. In fact, delta x might be more useful to us in the long run. Why is that? Well, as we set this up, think about the weight of the cable, and it's evenly distributed, okay? So the weight of the cable tells us that we have 300 feet per the 100 feet. Sorry, 300 pounds per the 100 feet. And that gives us 3 pounds per feet is the uniform density. Of the cable. Then the weight in the specific piece, or the force done, right? So subdivide the cable into n equal length pieces. Then the force done on each piece is the 3 pounds per foot, density, times delta x. And the work that we do, so the work is going to be the f sub I times x. How far we have to bring that piece up. So we end up with 3 delta x times x, sorry, x sub I. And so we find that the work done is the sum, and we're approximating, of course, 3 delta x times x sub I, which suggests that the actual expression that we need to simplify is the integral from 0 to 100 of 3x dx. Now, there's alternative ways of formulating this, right? But this is a standard way of doing this. Then, if we want to actually perform that integral, right, then the work is 3 halves x squared from 0 to 100. And then the 0 doesn't contribute anything, so then we just have 3 times 100 squared over 2, which yields 15,000 foot-pounds. And this is in foot-pounds because we are talking about imperial units. Okay, so not too bad. The next example is going to require a little bit more imagination, but we're going to break it down piece by piece. So in the next example, we're going to empty a water tank. And the shape is actually going to matter quite a bit. Okay. So I'm going to draw two pictures here, and they're both going to be important for understanding what we're dealing with. So I have here, I'm going to draw my water trough. Hope you bear with me while I draw this. Okay, that's not too bad. So imagine this is full of water, okay? And we know that the dimensions of this, so the height, imagine this is a, this is actually a, so this is the bottom of the tank. This is the top. It's a triangular prism. And the height is 3 meters. The length of the tank is 8 meters. And the width of the top is also 3 meters, okay? So to understand what's going on here, the triangular shape here, let me draw that in as well. So this is 3 meters, and this is also 3 meters. Okay, so we have a full picture now of what's going on here. And so what we need to imagine is that we're going to calculate the work required. Find the work required to pump out the water out of the top of the tank. We'll use one critical piece of information that isn't necessarily common knowledge. The density of water is 1,000 kilograms per meters cubed. Okay, so each layer of this tank, so we're going to imagine we have infinitesimally thin rectangular slabs here. If you bear with me again, I'm just going to imagine we have these slabs here. So that's an infinitesimally thin slab. And we need to think about what the work required in lifting that up, okay? So our task, we're gonna subdivide And our range here for x is going to be from 0 to 3, because we're starting from the bottom of the tank, 0 meters, all the way up to the top of the tank, 3 meters, into n sub-intervals of equal length, equal thickness, I guess, length, let's call it length. And when I say infinitesimally, that means because at some point we're going to take a limit. Right now we're going to work with the I notation, working with a finite amount of these. So x equals 0 is going to be the bottom of the tank. The endpoint is x equals 3. And so if we want to calculate the work, remember that for each I, Wi is going to be the force that we need to lift that slab times the distance, which is going to be not x, but it's going to be 3 minus x sub I, because at the very bottom, right, we're lifting that all the way up to the 3, and in the middle, we're lifting that up to 3. Every piece is relative to 3. So this is the actual infinitesimal piece here. What we don't know yet is how to calculate the force. But the force is actually just the weight of the slab. So in order to lift it up, we need to calculate the weight, which is going to be the density of water times the infinitesimal, or I shouldn't call it infinitesimal, but the volume of that slab times 3 minus x sub I. Okay? Now, again, we're adding more pieces to the puzzle here. The only part we still don't know is finding the volume of that rectangular slab. And that's where this diagram is going to come is going to be helpful. So given that this is the height x, what must be the width of that slab? And by similarity, okay, because this is this triangle, right, we have an inscribed triangle inside another one, so they're similar triangles, that must mean this is also x. Okay, take a moment to convince yourself of that fact, which means the volume of that slab is going to be the length of the slab times the width of the slab times the height of the slab. The length of the slab is the same as every one of them, which is 8. The width of the slab is, we already said, that's x. And the height of that slab is the delta x. That means fully the work necessary to lift up that slab is going to be 1,000 times 8xi delta xi times 3 minus xi. I really should be putting stars on the xi's. Sorry, because we're talking about sample points. But you understood, right? All right. And the total weight then, the total work is going to be the sum of these WIs. And in the limit, so we take the limit as n goes to infinity of the sum of I equals 1 to n of 1,000 times 8 x sub I star times delta x sub I times 3 minus x sub I star. Let's turn this into an integral, because this is an integral. Okay? So in the limit of the Riemann sum, means this will become the integral from 0 to 3 of 1,000 times 8x dx times 3 minus x. And if we clean this up a little bit, this means this becomes 0, the integral from 0 to 3 of 8,000 times 3 minus x, x dx. And now this is a polynomial, and we can pull out the 8,000, and it should be shouldn't be too bad. Okay, then 8,000 times 3x integrated is going to be 3x squared over 2 minus x squared means x cubed over 3 from 0 to 3. Again, 0 is not going to contribute anything, so we just have to plug in 3. So we have 8,000 times, which is going to end up being 3 cubed, because that's a times a 3, so that's 27 over 2 minus 27 over 3. And then when we combine those, right, we'll need to multiply by 3, by 2. Then we get 8,000, 81 over 6 minus 54 over 6. And then if we do, you know, if we cheat a little bit and use our phone calculator or whatever calculator you have available, okay, you got 27 over 6, and you can factor out a 3 from that, right? Yes. Yeah. Okay. Then 27 over 6 times 8,000. And I don't want to use a whole another page for this, so I'm just going to keep going here. So that's going to be 9, because I divided by 3. And divided by 3, that's 2. So the 8 and the 2 also will cancel, and that's going to be a 4, and it's going to be 1. So it's going to be 36,000. This time it's newtons, because our units, remember, were in meters. And the density of water times the volume is going to give us kilograms. So all together, this is it. Joules. All right, so some key things to keep in mind here. We can identify the force and infinitesimalize, but really the most valuable thing is to infinitesimalize the weight. Because when we do infinitesimalize the force, we need to keep in mind that each piece of the object that we're lifting, for instance, we're lifting at a certain distance, and that is actually going to give us our proper